Are you tired of the limited availability and skyrocketing prices of lithium-ion batteries for your devices and electric vehicles? Well, there's a new kid on the block, sodium-ion batteries. They're cheaper, more environmentally friendly, and even perform better in cold weather. So, are you ready to power up with sodium? Stay tuned to find out more. Before we start, just make sure you subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Hello and welcome to today's episode, where we will talk about Toyota's new solid-state battery technology that is set to revolutionize the electric vehicle industry. In simple terms, Toyota has developed a new battery technology that will allow electric cars to drive more than 1,000 kilometers on a single charge, retain almost all of its battery capacity even after 3 years of use, function normally in a range of temperatures, be recharged in just 10 minutes, and cost the same as a comparable combustion-powered car. The technology is set to be developed in large quantities by the middle of this decade, and today we will explore how this will change the electric vehicle market. Solid-state batteries have many advantages over existing lithium-ion battery technologies. Solid-state devices work over a larger temperature range, are safer, have a smaller and lighter design, and have a higher energy density. Lithium-ion batteries, which are commonly used in electric cars, use a liquid electrolyte solution that can swell or ignite if not handled carefully or if damaged. In contrast, solid-state batteries use a solid electrolyte that eliminates these problems while significantly improving the amount of power that can be stored in a battery. Toyota is investing the majority of its $18.7 billion investment in solid-state technology, which has more than 1,000 patents and is eventually expected to be produced on a massive scale. By putting several solid-state battery electric car prototypes into operation with the assistance of partner Panasonic, Toyota is attempting to move ahead of the curve. The claims made by Toyota are clear: while keeping 90% of its performance after 30 years, the solid-state battery has twice the range of a similar lithium-ion battery, and it can charge from empty to full in under 10 minutes. Toyota boasts its solid-state batteries can charge from empty to full in under 10 minutes, making audacious claims once more. However, mass production of its solid-state battery is not expected until 2025, as the technology is almost ready for mass adoption, but the production capacity isn't there yet. This is true of other players in the solid-state arms race as well. Solid-state batteries need unique production equipment and procedures, and the world has a finite supply of raw lithium, which is just not being produced enough. Nonetheless, Toyota has a fund provided by the Japanese government which is being used to support industry's attempts to develop innovative decarbonization technologies. The majority of the funds will be used to develop solid-state batteries, namely to buy the necessary lithium. From 2012 to 2022, the price of lithium has increased from $4,450 per ton to $78,032, a 1,066.54% increase over the last 10 years, and a 480% increase in the most recent year alone. However, there is a new innovative battery that CALT has to offer that costs only $15 per kilowatt hour, which is much cheaper than the $101 that a lithium-based battery costs. This is a sodium-ion battery that has been able to complement lithium-ion batteries and boost the energy density of the battery system by integrating the two battery systems. Sodium is a much more prevalent resource than lithium, and its use in batteries has the potential to replace lithium. The concentration of the electrolyte in sodium-ion batteries can be decreased, which decreases the cost by around 85%. Sodium-ion batteries also have better conductivity and are easier to obtain and cheaper. However, the sodium-ion battery's range is limited, and the range of EV models using this battery can be up to 310 miles, whereas the 4680 Model Y has a range of just 279 miles. Sodium-ion batteries can charge in 15 minutes to 80% at normal temperatures, while the Model Y from Tesla takes 32 minutes to recharge from 0% to 80%. Additionally, lithium-ion batteries operate best between 15 and 35 degrees Celsius, while there is no evidence that high temperatures cause a major decline in the efficiency of sodium-ion batteries. Sodium-ion batteries are also safer than lithium-ion batteries, as they are less combustible and are resistant to temperature changes and capable of high-voltage operation. The lengthy cycle life of sodium-ion batteries is made possible by the ultra-thin layer stability after it has been produced. However, there are still some challenges to commercializing sodium-ion batteries. Although they are less combustible than lithium-ion batteries, their volume is larger, and their kinetic and structural requirements are higher than those of lithium-ion batteries. The chemical composition of lithium metal batteries presents a number of obstacles while making substantial advancements, and the same is expected with sodium-ion batteries. Now, you might be thinking, what's a battery? A battery is a device that stores energy and releases it when it's needed. We use batteries every day, in our phones, laptops, and even our cars. They're an essential part of our modern lives. Right now, most of the batteries we use are lithium-ion batteries. They work really well, but they have a few drawbacks. For one thing, lithium is becoming more expensive and harder to find as electric cars become more popular. Also, lithium batteries can be a bit flammable, which is not ideal. That's where sodium-ion batteries come in. They use sodium instead of lithium, which is much cheaper and more abundant. Sodium batteries are also less likely to catch on fire, and they work well in cold temperatures. But there's a catch. Sodium batteries haven't been as good as lithium batteries in the past because they haven't been very durable. That means they don't last as long or store as much energy. However, researchers are working hard to improve sodium batteries, and they're making progress. One big advantage of sodium batteries is that they're more environmentally friendly than lithium batteries. That's because they don't use as many rare metals, which can be harmful to the environment. Sodium is a very common element that can be found in lots of places, like seawater and peat bogs. So why aren't we using sodium batteries already? Well, they're still in the research and development phase. But some companies, like China's CATL, are starting to incorporate sodium cells alongside lithium ones in electric car battery packs. This will help ensure that we have enough raw materials to meet the growing demand for electric cars. Sodium batteries are also well suited for use on the electrical grid. This means they could be used to store energy from renewable sources like solar and wind power. That way, we can use clean energy even when the sun isn't shining or the wind isn't blowing. However, there are still some challenges to overcome before sodium batteries can become widely used. For example, researchers need to develop new materials for the battery's cathode and anode, which are the parts of the battery that store and release energy. They also need to make sure that sodium batteries are safe and reliable. Despite these challenges, scientists and engineers are working hard to develop better sodium batteries. They believe that these batteries have great potential to power our homes, cars, and even our cities in a cleaner, more sustainable way. So that's a brief overview of sodium-ion batteries. We hope you learned something new today. In conclusion, with the global market for next-generation technology predicted to expand in value from $53.6 million a year to $34.6 billion in 2035, Toyota's solid-state battery technology is set to give them an advantage over China and South Korea in the battery production arms race. The new technology will change the electric vehicle market by making electric cars more affordable, efficient, and convenient for consumers. While we still have a few years to wait until mass production begins, we can expect to see a wave of new electric cars equipped with solid-state batteries soon. Thank you for watching today's episode, and I hope you learned something new about the exciting world of solid-state battery technology.